This pretty uncommon houseplant is called Kleinia fulgens, or Scarlet Kleinia, or sometimes I see it called Scarlet or Coral Senecio. And this one's a really beautiful one. I'm so glad I got this one. I'm growing this in full sun condition, and I've had it for about 3 years. The second year, it put out these really beautiful crimson or coral-colored pom-poms, and they lasted quite a long time, and it was putting them out in the middle of winter, which was awesome because you don't always get some really colorful flowers during the winter. Typically, when we think of flowers, they come out in the spring and summer months. But with that kind of red-colored pom-pom and this kind of verdigious, kind of whitish hue of this leaf, I just thought it was like a really, really attractive plant. This is actually typically from southern Africa and all throughout the south of Africa. And you could see that this is a more succulent variety and it actually grows in higher light conditions. So I have this growing directly in my windowsill, up against my window in full sun, southwest facing conditions. So it is getting bombarded with light. And I have to say that it's actually done very well throughout the winter because it presses its little leaf faces against my blustery little window in winter, and it does surprisingly fine. Also, I don't know if you could see this, but part of this is actually broken here, and still the tip of it is growing extremely well. So, and what's cool about it is it's a little bit like a woody plant. It starts to get a little bit more woodier and woodier, I believe, as it ages. And some of the leaves on the bottom are starting to come off and maybe die and get crispy, but it could be in relation to the amount of light that I'm actually giving it because it is really in some intense light. I'm watering it though still on a weekly basis because again, this is a plant, a succulent plant that could withstand some of the higher temperatures, some of that intense light and a lack of watering. You might also notice that some of the leaves actually have this kind of like lavender, purple, lilac hue. And again, that's some of the anthocyanins, which is coming out in the leaf that is used as an antioxidant to protect the leaf. So very similar to our melanin or that skin color that darkens as the sun hits us. As far as fertilizing goes, you could do this on a monthly basis and go with a lower fertilizer. So more like a cacti or succulent fertilizer, maybe like a 277 if you have something around those lines. Or you could even go with an organic succulent fertilizer, which may be like a 055 or a 111 or something along those lines. So look out for that. You could do it on a monthly basis and that should be totally fine for you. I haven't had any pest pressures with this particular plant. I would imagine that mealybugs might be attracted to this because a lot of mealybugs are attracted to a little bit more succulent varieties of plants, but I haven't had any issues whatsoever. So if you can actually find this plant, I would say get it, especially if you want some pops of color in the winter, because I was so thrilled when this actually flowered. Even though it didn't flower in the first year or the third year, I'm hoping that maybe in the fourth year, it'll put out some bright new pom-poms again.